We know that the justice system is anything but, and that race unfortunately has and always has and still does play a role in how the justice system treats people. But you don't very often get to directly compare two things and see the difference, but we can now. Because two Cuyahoga County Common Pleas Court judges gave very different sentences just this last week to two women, one black, one white, who stole public money in separate cases. There's some differences to the cases, but there's a lot of overlap. So let's talk about what ended up happening. A white woman stole nearly $250,000 from the village of Chagrin Falls. Judge Hollie Gallagher sentenced her on Monday to 2 years of probation. A black woman who stole $40,000 from Maple Heights City Schools went before Judge Rick Bell, who sentenced her Tuesday to 18 months in prison. So, very different amounts of money. One stole, I don't know, a little bit more than five times as much and is on probation, which isn't nothing, but it ain't prison. And another woman who stole far less, and she's gonna be in prison for 18 months. Maybe she'll get out a little bit earlier, but that is very different than probation there. So JR, what do you think about this?
Well, it's pretty obvious. The black woman must have stolen the $40,000 at gunpoint, you know, because it escalates the nature of the crime. She threatened someone, I think she put him in a chokehold or something like that. There was aggression for sure. You know, although the monetary amounts were different, or maybe this the little village of Chagrin Falls, maybe some reason maybe they're more vulnerable. Maybe it's a community that needs more help. I don't know. It's something definitely has nothing to do with the fact that this is a black woman.
Definitely not. No, nothing at all. It's pretty obvious. But look, there's more details about the cases, and I encourage you, if you're interested in this and in our justice system, to look it up and get there. We unfortunately don't have the time to go into it right now, but going forward, maybe something can be done about the sentences that have been given out. But in the future, there is an idea. So Cleveland leaders have called on the county's judges and judges around the state to join an Ohio Supreme Court pilot project that would create a public database to make transparent how judges sentence defendants and provide guardrails on judicial discretion that often results in unequal justice. Only 10 currently of the 34 has said that they plan to sign on to it. Six of those judges are in their first term on the bench. But look, this would not necessarily stop this same outcome from happening, but it would at least provide a data set that could be used to maybe inform public discourse about this and maybe some sort of legislation. In some cases, it might have to be state constitution amendments that would provide a little bit less leeway to judges to do what we're seeing acting out in the present day.
When it comes to something,
maybe a good outcome.
I feel like when it comes to something like sentences, hard numbers for what you're giving people for their crimes that they committed, there needs to be a standard set in place that we know what's coming. If you know you can sentence someone to 18 months versus 2 years, or then 2 years versus 5 years for the same or similar crimes, you should be able to have a standard to expect what's gonna come. It shouldn't be based off, oh, I happen to get the judge that likes to put people in prison for 2 days versus 2 years just for luck of the draw. The legal system is not a luck of the draw thing. And maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there's some kind of standard, it's written thing put in place that there's a standard and they just ignore it. Either way it goes, something's wrong here because there's no standard here. 100%. It's luck. And a lot of times it's racism.
100%. Really briefly, in grad school, I had to look into they did this analysis of, I think it was in Israel actually. It was judges, and they found that the sentences given right before the judges take their lunch break were far harsher than they give right after they come back from their lunch break.
It's insane.
It's insane. We give them the leeway, and this is how it gets manipulated. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.